Good morning, everyone. స్కూల్ బాగుండే ఇంట్లో కూర్చొని చేయట్లే అని చెప్పేసి చేపించిన. ఎనీవే ప్లాన్ చేద్దాం, దాని గురించి కూడా ప్రేయర్ ప్లాన్ చేద్దాం. మీటింగ్ స్టార్ట్ చేసి ఆల్రెడీ 8 మినిట్స్ అవుతుంది, బట్ ఇంకా చాలా మంది రాలేదు. రైట్, రేపటి నుంచి మీరు ఒక 6:55 నేను లింక్ పంపగానే ఇమీడియట్ జాయిన్ అవుతే ప్రేయర్ ఉంటుంది మేబీ మీకు. ఓకేనా? 6:55 కి జాయిన్ అవ్వడం ట్రై చేయండి. ఒక ఫోన్ అట్లా వంద టైం పడుతుంది కాబట్టి ఆ 5 మినిట్స్ మనం ప్రేయర్ చేసుకున్నాం. ఎనీవే రైట్, నన్ను హౌ మెనీ ఆఫ్ యూ డన్ ద హోంవర్క్ ఇస్టర్డే? Did I give you any homework? No, right? No. Anyway. Yeah. Anavi.
Yes, no. Sir.
No. Did you complete the homework? Anyway, right. Down your hands, all of you, and HMHS and KHS people, you got the user IDs and password, Nana. I sent you our respective teachers or what are the in charges. I gave them. Please collect your password and ID from your charges, and I will send you one tutorial video also. Watch that and try to join into the practical app. Okay. Right. We get into topic. Irrational numbers. Irrational numbers. Yes, what are irrational numbers, Nana? We discuss about these things in detail, right? Okay, the numbers which we cannot written in the form of p by q, where q not equals to 0, p comma q are integers. Okay, let me give you example. √3/2, √5/3, so on. Okay, sir, they are in look like p by q only, sir. Then why they are not rational numbers? See, here they are in the form of p by q only, but the condition is p comma q are integers, right? But here this √5 and √3 are not integers, Nana. Okay, yes, Nana. So that they are irrational numbers. And one more property also I have given. A natural number which is under root, which is not a perfect square. The natural number is not a perfect square. Under the root is an irrational. Example, what are the examples we have now? √6, √8, and √12, so on. All these are irrational numbers. Okay, one more note also we have. What is that, Nana? All those things. Anyway, once again I will repeat. The prime number under the root is is called an irrational. A root, if you have a prime number, is an irrational root 3, root 2, root 7, root 11, so on. All these are irrational numbers, right? Okay. And one more thing, non-terminating, non-recurring decimals, non-terminating, non-recurring decimals or non-terminating decimals are called irrational numbers. Okay, all these are irrational numbers. Example, we can write many now. 1.21, 31, 41, 51, 61, 2, 3, 4, 5, so on. It is not repeating and not terminating, right? Suppose if you take 2.01, 001, 2, 3, 4, 002, 1, 3, 5, 5, so on. Like this, we can take many numbers. Okay, we can create many numbers. Okay, right? Any doubts up to here? You can raise. Any doubts? Please raise your hands. Any doubts, Nana? Music came again. The time? Same, right? Maintains. Nice timing. Okay, right. Next. Yeah. What is the topic we have in your textbook? Decimal expansion of irrational number. Decimal expansion of irrational numbers. You know, if it is in the form, if it is rational number, you know how to convert that into a decimal form, right? We take usual division and we convert that into a decimal form, isn't it? Then what about this irrational numbers? How do you convert that into decimal form? We have a separate method for them. Already you have a decimal expansion for root 2 in your textbooks. Please look at that once. I think some people may understood, some people may not understood. I'll explain that first, okay? Because of that, for that we need some more space. See Nana here. Decimal expansion of root 2. Root 2. So, it's good to forget about that root and take 2 as 2.00000000001. Okay, right? So, make them pairs. It means take the pair of zeros like this. Okay, right? Clear? Next, see, important. Expect a long question, useful to in the further education also. Please take that and carefully. Steps we are going to see here, you never seen before, right? See. Now, I'm telling root 2 decimal expansion, you know, for that take 2.00000 and make zeros as pairs. To divide, generally what we do, Nana, we shall check how many maximum goes from the 2, right? Suppose if I take 1, 1 is a 1, right? What is the remainder? 1 is the remainder, right? 1 is the remainder. Now what you do is add this 1 plus this 1. Add this 1 and this 1. See what it becomes. 1 plus 1, 2 you get. Okay. So first of all, I have taken 1 into 1, 1 and subtracted 1 I get. And 1 plus this divisor and quotient, 1 plus 1, I got 2. I write 2 here and bring these 2 zeros here. Next, suppose shall check. Suppose if I want to, if I write 1 here, and you need to multiply with 1. Okay. Suppose that is not enough. Take 2 and multiply with 2. If it is okay, then okay. If it is not okay, go for 3 and multiply with 3. 3 is a 9. 3 2 is a 6. 69. So 69 is smaller than 100. We have a possibility more, right? You can take 24. I mean, take 4 here. Take 4 here and multiply with 4. Okay, what becomes? 4 4 is 16. 4 2 is 8 and 9. Right? So take 4 here as well. We have 2 here and that 4. This 4 into 4 here. Just I have taken this 4 now. Okay, before going to that, very sorry, I forgot to take a decimal point here. See here. Take a decimal point. Next here. Ready. This 1 plus this 1, 2 and take a point and I'm multiplying with 4 here, 4 and 4 here, 4 into 4, right? 24 into 4, you got 96. Okay, clear? Once again, I will repeat. So first, 1 into 1, 1, 1 and subtract 2 minus 1, 1 we got and this 1 plus this 1, we got 2 here and next by calculations. Okay, next we have taken here point because we need to drop these zeros, right? So take point here and drop these 2 zeros here. And if you multiply with 1, you need to multiply with 21 and 1, right? So I tried 24 into 4. Okay. That is enough to take here and take, okay. What is the remainder now? Remainder is 4, right? Okay. And next, double this now. Or else double this. 1.4 you have already. So, forget about the point. Consider it as 4 and 14. And 14 plus 14 is 28, right? Okay, just forget about the decimal point. Decimal point, just consider it is a 14. 14 plus 14, it is a 28. Okay, and for this decimal point, already we have decimal point, right? So bring 2 more zeros here. We get that. Forget about this decimal point. Consider it is as a 14. And add one more 14 plus double it 14 plus 14, we will get 28, right? And write 28 here. In the earlier case also, we have take, we can take this double as 1, okay? 28, okay. Next, suppose if I take 1 here, need to drop one more, drop one is here also, okay? 281, right? Did you get this, Nana? Next. What is the remainder? To take barrow from here. 10 minus 1, 9. And 9 minus 8, 1. 3 minus 2, 1. Okay. And this is considered as 141. 141. Okay. And if you double it, what becomes? 141. 282. 282, right? Isn't it? Is it clear? So write 282 here and we have decimal point. So drop two more zeros here. Two more zeros here. Okay. So now 282. If you want to if you want to check with one, 1 into 1, it becomes 2821. Let's say one more number. 2825. Right, becomes 5 5s are 25, 5 2s are 10, and 2 is already there. 5 5s are 25, 2 5 2s are 10, 12, 1 carry. Next 5 8s are 40, 41, 5 2s are 10, 14, 14 125. Is it enough? Is it right actually? Any mistake? Just 1 second, we should check. Five fives are 25. Please carry. 5 2s are 10, 12, 2 here, 1 here, 5 8s are 40. 41. 1 here. Carry 5 2s are 10. Yeah. 14 125. Is it sufficient? It's more than that, right? More than that. So we shall take 2824 into 4, right? How much? 2824? 211, 296 we get. Multiply 2824 into 4. You will get 11,296. That is sufficient to take here, right? So next take here. 4 and 4 here. Okay. So what is the difference? Barrow from here, 10 minus 6, 4, 9 minus 9, 0, 8 minus 2, 6, 6, 0, 4. Okay. And so what is that now? 1.414. Forget about the point, it becomes 1414 and double it, 1414, multiplying with 2 or adding again. EI 2. EI2. Right here. 2828 now. Okay. And because of this point, bring this 2 zeros here. Okay. Did you get up to here? You can continue the same procedure. Next, see. So 2828. Yeah, 60,400 we have here. So in which how many times it will come to take sufficient number to that 60,400? We'll see. Is it 1 is possible? No. 2 is possible. Is it possible to 28282? 28282 into 2. 2 is a 4, 2 is 6. 2 8s are 16, 1 here, 2 to the 4 and 5, 2 8s are 16, 1, 2 to the 4 and 5, 5 6, 5 6 4, I think it's sufficient to take, right? 2 8, we got 16, 2 is sufficient to take, you know, right? So take 2 here, the 2 here. Okay, what it becomes 56,564. You subtract, you'll get how much? 10 minus 4, 6, 9 minus 6, 3, and 3. So, arrow from here, 13 minus 5. This is remaining right here. 13 minus 5 is 8, 9 minus 3, 6. 3836 we got. Okay, so we can stop here. So we got, this is the decimal expansion of root. If we continue like that, it will be repeated. I mean, the process will be repeated, not the quotient. Okay, so this is the decimal expansion of root 2 up to 4 decimals, because we have 4 decimals, right? 4142. So decimal expansion of root 2 up to 4 decimal places. Okay. Now, if you have any doubt, you can raise the hand to ask. Yes, now please raise the hands. Nobody is having a doubt. Yes, Nana. Yes, sir.
Sir, good morning.
Good morning,
sir. I want to give a strictly warning to our students. Why? Because they are daily, they are offering their videos. Vaishnavi, Shravan, Apurva, Bindu. Why you people are offering? Then, sir, make them... waiting room, sir. Just send them to waiting room.
Yeah, okay.
Please. Okay, I spoke to our correspondent, sir. Sir said those who are not showing their videos, just put them in waiting room.
Okay, sir. Definitely.
Sir, thank you, sir. Thank you. Sorry for disturbance, sir.
No problem, sir. Okay. Thank you. Lakshmi Kirtika.
Sir, it won't stop us, sir. Sir, I can't hear, sir.
If you continue the process will be continued, Nana. Suppose if I ask you up to 20 decimals, you can do up to 20 decimals also. Okay? Because what is the definition of irrational numbers? I told you, non-terminating, non-repeating. Non-terminating, non-repeating. If you continue, goes on, the quotient will also continues. Okay. Right? The next, any more? Yes, Nana. Wait. Wait, Nana, did that means? How many of you joined from practically app, Nana? Please raise the hands. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10 members. 11. Did you join from practically at Lakshmi Kirtika? Please down your hand, Nana. Eleven people. Now, Hari, did you get the password? I think you don't. Only MRMS people are having the access. Okay. So if you join from practical app, then only you will get the attendance, Nana, official attendance. Okay. So already I tried to download the practical app as soon as possible. Okay. Just wait. 37 comes. Don't know who left. Answer this only. Manga Devi, write your name, Nana. Showing your brother name. Okay, anyway. Right. Anybody has any doubts? No doubt. Very good. Take the screenshots from first paper onwards. Okay. First page now. Second page. Third page. Okay, try to join 2-3 minutes before the class, Nana, if I send link. And if you join from practically, you can directly get into the class. Okay, we'll take small prayer before the class. Okay, Nana? Yeah, shall we stop here? Yes? Yeah, write down today's homework, Nana. Find the decimal expansion of root 3 and root 5. Two numbers now. For root 3 you have to find and root 5 you have to find. Up to 3 decimals only. Up to 3 decimals. No need to go for long. Up to 3 decimal place. Okay, that's enough. For the sake of practice, you can give me. And while writing the homework, what you have to do, must write your date and day and time as well. Number of homework, right? Okay. Right, Nana. Have a nice day. We'll meet you tomorrow. Bye, all of you. Bye, Nana.